Good day everyone, this is Xxyoth and today we are creating something like this using blueprints in Unreal Engine 4. So what do we see here? When X gets inside the enemy collision range, the animation changes and the current health went down. Then we could create some particle effects showing that he got damaged. The player is unable to move the character as soon as it got hit. This could be done in two ways. Creating a variable and setting which functions are not available, like jumping or moving, or using the disable input function from the engine. Now the player may move the character, but it can't receive damage as long as we see it blinking. This can also be done in two ways, with a variable and checking after it overlaps with the enemy, or changing the response to the channel to ignore. After the blinking ends, X can receive damage again. We start by going to the project settings, collision, and because our main character as well as the enemy character are pawns in this project, I'm going to show how to use a tag on an actor to identify the different pawns. We set a pawn to overlap with the other pawns. You can always use different channels as I did in a video a long time ago. Now we can edit our main character blueprint. Click here and search for tag. Add one element and I wrote player to identify this playable character. Then we create four new variables, two booleans and two floats. The isImmune boolean should be set to false and the inputs enabled should be set to true by default. We also add a branch before each function we want to disable if the player got hit. In this case it's the movement, jump, wall slide and wall jump. But I also added this after the timeline on the camera system from the last video. But that's not necessary. The max health float variable is the one we need with a value. The current health will be always updated. When you begin to play, the max health value is the current one, and that's all for now. When the actor receives damage, first we check if the actor is immune. If not, we update the current health, which is this variable minus the damage received. Then we check if the current health is under zero. If that's true, then we could check for lives or go to a continue or a stage select screen, whatever you want. If not, then we set the isImmune variable to true. The other way would be changing the collision response to the pawn channel to ignore. This would avoid the event any damage to start, while the actor cannot overlap with another pawn. If you have the camera system from the previous video, set it to false to stop for a short time while getting hit. Now this is the interesting part. First we set the inputs enabled to false, to avoid unnecessary movement from the player. Then we check if the actor is on air. If that's true and the actor maybe was jumping, we stop the jump, set the velocity to zero and launch the character on a minus value from the forward vector to get pushed back. If the actor was on the ground, then we set the ground friction to zero to get the same pushback distance as if it was on air when being launched. Now this delay is the time in which the player won't be able to move or jump. After that, we set the previous value for the ground friction, set inputs enabled to true and the camera offset to. Then we have a delay for how long this actor should stay immune while the player can move. After that, we set the pawn collision response to overlap or the isImmune boolean to false. That's all for the playable actor. I created a new folder called enemy and duplicated the playable actor. But I deleted almost every node and variable. Now we have the health variables as well as a damage float. The event begin play is the same for the enemy to set the current health. When the actor overlaps with this capsule component, we check if it is valid and then if that actor has a player tag. If that's true, then we apply damage, which must be above zero to work. Now we can test this and see if it works. and it does work. But I see a small problem. The player can overlap and stay inside the other capsule after getting hit once, and won't receive damage after not being immune anymore. This could lead to many gameplay exploits. It should look like this. To avoid this, we are going to refresh the collision response from the damaging enemy with a small delay, which should be shorter than the immune delay. So let's test this once again. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you did enjoy it, please subscribe and spread the word.